Hey everyone, welcome back. So today we're going to be looking at another great eShop deals video. Now today's list is going to be really indie heavy. It's simple, with Black Friday right around the corner, a lot of the mainstream publishers have toned down their eShop deals. But there's still quite a few games on sale, and like I said, a lot of really, really great indie titles. Now, as we go through the list, since this is a weekly thing I do on my channel, any games that I've covered in the previous week, I'll still point the deals out, but we won't go into details into the games. And if you want to see a little bit of a description of what the game is all about, you can check out my last week's video. If I specify that it was there, it's guaranteed it's in that video. There are also quite a few deals on the eShop that are wrapping up, so if you see me ignore the deals that say 2 or 3 hours remaining, it's just because as of filming this video, by the time it's up on YouTube, these deals will already be over. So I don't want to be talking about deals that you guys can't actually grab. Now if you like what you're seeing, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel if you aren't already. Now the first game on our list is Dragon Ball Xenoverse 2. Now this is not, unfortunately, the best Dragon Ball storyline game, but it is pretty much the best we have on the Switch for the moment. And honestly, for only $10, if you want to scratch that Dragon Ball itch, it's a great time playing through the game. At its full price, it's not necessarily a game I would have recommended, but for only $10, if you're a fan of the Dragon Ball series, this is a good game. If you don't know anything about Dragon Ball, I would stay away though. Next, three games that were in last week's video that the deals are wrapping up in the next 2 days but are still awesome pickups: Katamari Damacy Reroll, which is a really laid-back puzzle solver; Tales of Vesperia, which is a great classic JRPG style game but done in 3D in a modern fashion; and lastly, Dragon Ball Z Fighters, which is one of the best fighting games available on Switch right now. At the low, low prices these games are offered for right now, these are awesome pickups. Once again, another series that I featured in the previous video, the Naruto Shippuden Ultimate Ninja Storm series. All three games are 50% off, so you can pick them all up for $10 or less. It is an awesome series if you're a fan, once again, of Naruto. If you don't really know what Naruto is, or you're just not into anime, once again, I would stay away from these games, but if not, they are awesome pickups at $10. Now the next two games on our list are a couple of great retro-styled 2D platformers. The first is Goblin Sword. Now Goblin Sword is more of a really traditional 2D platformer, and it's just great because the mechanics are awesome, the game is fun, although simplistic. However, at $1.99, it's a good time. For $5, it was still way worth it, and at $1.99, if you're looking for a retro-styled 2D side-scroller to play, Goblin Sword is a great game to pick up. It's not a very long game, so you'll be done with it pretty quickly, but there are some replay values trying to play through the game with the different type of swords, because that is the main focus of the game, is basically trying out all the different type of goblin swords, which really changes up the gameplay totally. Now the next game on our list is an incredible discount at only 99 cents right now. So normally this game is sold at $10, it's 90% off, and that is Ghoul Boy. Ghoul Boy is even more retro styled with more of a pixel art feel. However, at the same time, Ghoul Boy has some really, really interesting mechanics. Basically, it centers a lot more around platforming. The puzzle solving isn't difficult, but you will have to a couple of times try and find a different path around the stage than just right to left. Basically, you're gonna have to think a little bit in this game, and you have a really interesting mechanic using your spear to create new platforms. Once again, at 99 cents, this is an amazing pickup. Now, staying a little bit with the retro theme, the next game on our list is the Namco Museum Archives Volume 1. And in my opinion, Volume 1 is the stronger of the two volumes. And to my recollection, this is the first time I see this discounted. Basically, normally this is always sold for $19 and it sells at $19. That's why they don't discount it. So to have 40% off and getting it for $12, which basically with 11 titles makes it only about $1 a title, it is great. And if we look at the list of titles, you have Pac-Man, Xevious, Mappy, Dig Dug, Tower of Druaga, Sky Kid, Dragon Buster, Dragon Spirit the New Legend, Splatterhouse Wampaku Graffiti, and Pac-Man Championship Edition. Now, if you don't know these names, these are like the classic arcade games that, you know, everyone grew up with in the 80s. And even I would say Wampaku Graffiti is a Splatterhouse, is an awesome 2D side scroller that really wasn't released in North America originally. It was like a Japan exclusive. So this collection is really awesome. And at $12, in my opinion, if you're a fan of retro gaming, it's a definite pickup. Next on our list, we have Romancing Saga 3. Now this is a remaster of a Super Nintendo game, and it is a really, really old school classic JRPG. If you're gonna play this game, make sure you know what you're getting into, because there's a lot of hours to put in, 30 or more, and also this game really doesn't hold your hand. It's like the original classic JRPGs where you really gotta figure out sometimes where you gotta go on your own, and it's not like today where you have NPCs telling you exactly what the next step is. But if you love the classic JRPGs, this is an awesome one, and artistically, the design on the bosses and the pixel art is among some of my favorite on the SNES. Next on our list, we have the Namco Museum Archives Volume 2. Once again, it's a great pickup because it's only $12 rather than its normal $20. Once again, this is another collection that is normally not discounted. It has 11 titles. As I said earlier, my preference is for Volume 1, but Volume 2 still has some really solid titles in Galaga, Battle City, Pac-Land, Dig Dug 2, Super Xevious, Mappy Land, Legacy of the Wizard, Rolling Thunder, Dragon Buster 2, Mendel Palace, and Gapless. Awesome games, but often they are basically sequels to the games in Volume 1. And personally, if you're gonna play a game, I like playing the original one, but the sequels are still great games in their own right. Now, if you catch this video quick, I'm so sorry I missed this game in last week's deals video. Sometimes with, you know, over 500 deals a week, you miss a few, but there is still one day remaining on it. So if you watch this video when it just comes out, you'll be able to pick it up pretty easily. And that is Power Rangers Battle for the Grid. Of course, if you're a fan of Power Rangers, this is like a must-have game, because this is actually a Power Rangers fighter, but it is well done. It is actually better than anyone would have thought this game was gonna be. And it was launched as a budget title originally as well, meaning that a lot of people didn't have much expectations for it. But trust me, this is probably one of the best Power Rangers games to ever come out. And if you want a one-of-a-kind Power Rangers experience, grab Battle for the Grid. And it is actually a decent fighter in its own right, even for someone who's not a fan of Power Rangers. It's not, however, the best fighter out there, which is why I'm saying that its fans of Power Rangers will appreciate it even more. However, get ready that if you want the full version of the game, it is going to cost you a little more. There is the deluxe pack that is discounted with the additional downloads in it. It's also 40% off right now, but it is still about double price to what this is here. So the $12 is a good way to try out the game, see if you want to invest in the downloadable content. However, if you want to grab everything at a discounted price for once, go look for the deluxe pack. It's a little bit lower on the list and it'll be discounted as well. So the next game on our list is another awesome indie title, Butcher, that is being sold right now at 70% off for only $2.99. Now, this game is an awesome 2D shooter. It is hyper violent and hyper aggressive, so it's maybe not for your kids if you're buying it for younger viewers. But if you're buying it for an adult or you're just yourself as a teenager, this is a great 2D shooter. Of course, it's pixel art, so the violence is sort of not very realistic, but it is an awesome game to pick up, and it's another awesome indie game. Now, the next game on our list is really a great pickup for $5, and that is Zombie Blast Crew, which actually just launched this month on the eShop. It's a top-down shooter, so it's basically a third-person top-down shooter. However, it's a really awesome game, and I'm actually working on a full review for this game right now, so keep tuned if you're interested. It'll be released this week, and there's still 14 days left on the deal, so if you want to wait for that full review before buying it, just check it out when it comes out in a few days. But spoilers ahead, it is really worth it for $5. It is not the best game on the eShop, but it is a super solid pickup for $5. It'll offer you hours of fun. Anyway, I think I've said enough. check out the review if you want more information in a couple of days, and if not, take the plunge. $5 is worth it for this game. So once again, two more mentions from last week's video, Val Ferris and Slain Back from Hell. These two games at one 50% off, the other one 75% off, are once again great 2D side-scrollers. Both in Val Ferris is more of a shooter, Slain is more of a melee action game. So basically, once again, these two games are awesome pickups. You don't have to worry about it. If you haven't played them yet, they are great games. Metagal is also still on sale for a couple of days at $3.24. This is really almost like a Mega Man clone, so if you like that type of 2D action game, awesome pickup, and at only $3.24, it's basically a steal. So once again, Metagal is another great pickup. If you want more information, check out last week's video. So I know you guys are maybe fed up of the 2D side-scroller indie games, but Oniken is another great one. And at only $2.49, it's really hard to go wrong as long as the game is solid. This on my list so far would probably be the weakest of the 2D side-scrollers, just fun-wise, but it is still a great pickup and it really is a great retro pixel art style. You have some stages where you're riding a motorcycle, some where you're platforming, some that are more action-based. And at $2.49, it's really hard to go wrong. So right now, if you want to pick up a lot of really cheap games and play them over the next few months, these are really all really great retro pickups. So here we are, guys. We're at the last game on our list, and that is Radio Squid. Once again, an indie retro title. I'm sorry, guys. It's just like that this week. But it is an awesome pickup at $3.49, but I do want to give one warning. The game is really short, and this game has been done in the retro Game Boy style in a black and white format with just little splashes of colors here and there. However, the chiptune music is awesome, the feeling is amazing, the gameplay is really solid. The only problem with the game is that after 2 or 3 hours, you'll be done. And that's maybe a shout out to the producers of this game. If we can get a follow-up to it, but with a good like 5 to 6 hour campaign, it would be an amazing, amazing offering. However, at $3.49, if you want to spend some of the 2 to 3 best hours ever in gameplay, like retro style gameplay, then pick up Radio Squid. It's an awesome pickup at $3.49, in my opinion. However, I do want to give the warning that 2 or 3 hours max for the campaign. So that's it for this week's list. Now, it was indie heavy, but what's awesome is the games are really, really cheap. Almost every game on the list was under $10, and almost every game you can easily pick up and play further down the road. Now, if you're into Black Friday deals, I will be coming out probably very shortly with more Black Friday deal videos, because right now we're getting a full lay of the land on who has the best deal for each game. Also, I want to hear from you in the comments. If you picked up any of these games, I really want to know which ones you picked up. Also, in your opinion, if I missed any great games that I should have included on this list, let me know. I might have just not tried them yet, and I'll try to try them and include them in future eShop videos. As I said earlier, to help out the channel, don't forget to hit the like button if you liked what you're seeing, and subscribe if you aren't already. Also, hit the notification bell so you know when all my videos are coming out. And as usual, I hope I'll see you guys in the next one.